I grew up on the ocean. It's in my bones, my heart, and in my soul. It was always going to be an important part of my life. In April of last year, I was given the biggest opportunity to explore the oceans of the world, broaden my understanding, and discover my interests. My year began in Exmouth, Western Australia, where I helped Rolex Award for Enterprise winner Brad Norman with his work on the EcoOcean visual database for whale shark encounters.
Well, it was back in 1995 that we worked out how to identify individual sharks through their spots on their skin. And it's progressed since then to become a citizen science project where anybody in the world who gets to swim with a whale shark can actually become a whale shark researcher just by taking a photo.
Once you take a photo, you can submit it to the EcoOcean database, where the spot patterns are compared to hundreds of others using NASA Hubble Telescope technology for mapping stars. I also helped Peter and Nico from Customized Animal Tracking Solutions with their whale shark tagging project. I learned all about the workings of the daily diary tags that measure a number of variables, including acceleration, temperature, depth, and light levels. My next stop was Rodney Fox Shark Expeditions with my awesome coordinator, Jane Jenkins. White sharks are so graceful to watch underwater. They're perfectly adapted animals, and I believe that they have every right, just like us, to swim in this ocean. I hope through education like that given by Rodney Fox, that eventually the general public will learn to respect them.
Oh, that's so cool!
What's that many?
Woo!
Figuring out how to use my underwater camera and video camera equipment early on sounded like a really good idea, and thanks to Richard Brooks in Palau, I was given expert training and advice. Richard taught me about the essence of filmmaking, the importance of having a purpose and knowing the story that you want to share. I also got to help Gabriel Viana with his work assessing the success of Palau's Shark Sanctuary.
So I'm out at Short Drop-Off Reef in Palau, and we've been trying to catch some sharks this morning. We were moderately successful.
I then headed to New Zealand to do my rebreather course with the famous Pete Mesley. Learning my rebreather was like learning to dive again. It was humbling, challenging, and often a completely infuriating process. But thanks to Pete, I passed my exam and thoroughly enjoyed diving at the Paul Knights. Pete also helped me with my photography, and I now know how to take a perfectly balanced Barbie photo. Of course, some nice ones of the marine life as well. I've always wanted to see what it would be like to work in an international conservation organisation. So I packed my bags and headed halfway across the world to Switzerland, where I volunteered at the IUCN World Heritage Programme and the World Wildlife Fund. It was so amazing seeing the IUCN and meeting the people that work there after years of imagining what it would be like. My travels then took me to one of the most unlikely places. It's a country that conjures up a feeling of mystery, intrigue, and closure. Yet despite all the propaganda, Saudi Arabia has one of the best universities for studying marine biology in the world. The King Abdullah University of Science and Technology is situated a stone's throw from the Red Sea, and I went there to help Julia Spate with her work on reef sharks. Unfortunately, Julia's work has revealed extremely low numbers of sharks in the waters off Saudi Arabia, causing her to spend a lot of her time taking genetic samples of sharks from the local markets. Going to the Jeddah market was one of the biggest eye-openers on my scholarship year. It was clear that this is where a lot of the marine life in Saudi Arabia ends up nowadays, no longer in the water, but instead splayed across benches, tables, and even the concrete floor of the Jeddah Market. So how do we go about conserving marine life in areas where it's crucial for people's survival? My interest in marine conservation brought me to the Coral Triangle, and in particular, Papua New Guinea. Dr. Joshua Sinner studies traditional customary management strategies in Papua New Guinea, which can be similar to modern marine conservation strategies, and include closing reefs to fishing, restricting the seasons when people fish, and limiting the species that can be caught. I help Josh and his team survey community members who were asked questions about their income and expenditures, and if they were fishermen, extra questions were asked about which gear types they use and how often they fish. With the ecological team, I helped figure out how successful these traditional schemes were by conducting surveys of fish and coral abundance inside and outside traditional protected areas. The two islands we visited showed completely different levels of reef health, and it was apparent from the surveys that people differed in their reliance on fish, resulting in the complete breakdown of traditional management on the island with lower reef health. I came away from the experience realizing that if we are to try to protect coral reefs in these areas, we need to make the effort to understand the local culture and the socioeconomic conditions at play before we suggest a uniform and undeviating conservation strategy. I landed in the USA and met a huge range of people in Southern California and Las Vegas, where I attended the DEMA show. It's definitely one of the most valuable parts of the scholarship, being able to make contacts with so many people that are experts in their field. After DEMA, I headed to Costa Rica, where I practiced my underwater videography skills on the most photogenic creatures on the planet, hammerhead sharks. At Cocos, white tips have learnt to hunt using diver torchlight. Hundreds of sharks move like little mini tornadoes, all honing in on the smell of prey. Some opportunities materialise in the scholarship that you just really cannot believe are possible. One such experience for me was getting to explore an environment so remote that it is literally the least explored place on Earth, the deep sea.
So we're now at a depth of 145 meters, and as you can see, it's pretty dark around us, but we can actually, looking out of the bubble here, we have a full 360 degree view of everything. We've just seen a really massive mobule array.
2 meters. Well, here we are, yep. We're in 300 meters. How do you feel?
Very, very happy. I can't believe I made it down here today.
Cave diving is something that I've always been intrigued about, and I readily took up the opportunity to do my Cavern and Intro to Cave course with Christina Zanatto in the Bahamas. Christina is an amazing teacher. She exudes such excitement and passion for cave diving that you can't help but assume some of her enthusiasm. Cave diving is a totally different type of diving. It's so beautiful and stunning in those caves, and thanks to Christina and Oscar Svensson, these dives ended up being some of the best of my year. It was then time to head to Washington, D.C., to Northwest Coordinator Allison Labronte, where I would do some more work with non-profit conservation organizations. I also got to see the President's inauguration and accompanied Allison on a dive into the Chile Potomac to raise awareness of climate change.
Climate action!
As my year came to a close, I realized that I love working in conservation and educating people to live more sustainably. But I also realized that working indoors, far away from the ocean, might not be the best plan for me, at least in the near future. Being outside, feeling the wind on my face, and exploring the ocean, these are the things that really make me feel most alive, most happy, and this was reinforced by my final year experience. So I couldn't have asked for a more spectacular way to finish what has been the most incredible and sometimes crazy and hectic year as a Rolex scholar. I'm actually on my way down to Antarctica at the moment with Oceanwide Expedition. It was a weird sensation getting to reach a continent that I had never thought I would get the chance to go to in my lifetime. The scholarship has given me opportunities that most people wait their entire lives for. Finally getting to dive and feel that icy water on my face was just unbelievable. We got incredible wildlife interactions in Antarctica, and for me, the leopard seal won hands down. I don't know about you, but I think leopard seal propulsion is a pretty cool way of getting around. Thankfully, we didn't get any punctures. I realized that I really enjoyed filming my year. While I'm certainly not naive to the difficulties of working in this industry, I'd love to keep working at it and see where it takes me. My year could not have been a more valuable journey, allowing me to broaden my interests, grow as a person, and self-discover. With such an amazing year, for me comes a great sense of responsibility and obligation to become something great with this gift that has been given to me. I'm looking forward to what the future holds, but mostly I'm grateful to all of you. You have changed my life.
Donut.